The story of Medusa is a sad one, a tale of unjust blame and the power of rage, further saddened by her undeserved fate. So this video is dedicated to her story. Starting with a sculpted head, we will procedurally generate a cluster of snakes and then animate them, all with a simple geometry node setup. To get things going, in addition to the figure of Medusa, we need a separate object containing only the scalp. With this scalp object selected, go to the Modifiers tab, add a geometry node modifier, and give it a proper name. Then head over to the geometry node workspace, which currently only contains two nodes. So use the Add menu and the search field to bring in a Distribute Points on Faces node, a Quadratic Bezier node, and an Instance on Points node. On the distribute node, set the distribution method to Poisson disk and increase the minimum distance. On the quadratic Bezier node, lower the resolution, but more importantly, make sure that the start point is at zero and the middle and end points are lined up along the z-axis, as this will guarantee that the snakes grow outward from the head. As you can see, the minimum distance on the distribute node controls the frequency of the snakes on Medusa's head, while the endpoint of the quadratic Bezier node determines the length of the snakes. Now to give the snakes some volume and a material, press Shift A to once again bring up the Add menu and use the search field to drop in a Curve Circle node, a Curve to Mesh node, and a Set Material node. Here, the curved circle is used as the profile for the curve to mesh node and turns each individual curve into a cylinder that makes up the body of the snakes. Adding heads to the end of each body comes a bit later, but now is the time to tell Blender what material to use for the slimy skins of these slithering snakes. Now to give Medusa an ominous look, let's contort the snakes in random directions by adding a noise texture node, a map range node, a Realize Instances node, and finally a Set Position node. Lower the scale value and the details on the Noise Texture node, then switch the Map Range node from Float to Vector. The scale value on the Noise Texture node controls the frequency of the contortions along the snakes, but if you look closely, you will notice that the base of the snakes are not attached to the scalp, and it looks like they are just floating around Medusa's head instead of growing out from it. This is the result of adding random noise values along the entire length of each snake. But don't fear, there is an easy yet clever fix for this, where all we need is a Spline Parameter node, a Map Range node, and a Vector Math node with its operation set to scale. The special node here is the Spline Parameter node and its factor output. This factor output starts from 0 at the base of the curve and increases to 1 at the end of the curve. So passing this factor through the Map Range node and the subsequent Scale node eliminates the effect of random noise at the base of each curve, meaning that the snakes are now directly attached to Medusa's scalp. Keep in mind that you can use the parameters on the Map Range node to adjust the intensity of the contortions. Before we go ahead and add heads to these snakes, I have to warn you not to stare directly into Medusa's eyes, or you will turn to stone and won't be able to like this video and comment about your favorite interpretation of Medusa's story. And now, go ahead and create a model for the snake head. Here, I'm using a low poly cone with a subdivision modifier attached to it. Now, take a deep breath and add an endpoint selection node, an object info node, a curve tangent node, an align Euler to vector node, an instance on points node, and finally, a join geometry node. The first uncommon, yet important node here, is the Endpoint Selection node, which allows us to select a subset of points along either end of a curve. In this case, we are only selecting the very first point at the end of each curve. The second important node is the Align Euler to Vector node, which takes the tangent of the curve and uses it to align each individual head with the body. And now, as we approach the moment you have all been waiting for, that is, to animate the twists and turns of Medusa's snakes, let me remind you that if you don't have time to read the sad story of Medusa's fate, the next best thing is to listen to the sad story of Medusa's fate. Check the description for an amazing deal on your next audiobook subscription. And to animate the snakes, add a scene time node and a math node with its operation set to multiply. Now play the animation, and behold, your reincarnation of a captivating creature with catastrophic countenance. Now, if you haven't turned into stone yet, here's another video for you. Also, don't forget that you can get the project files for this tutorial using the link in the description. As for this one, thank you for watching, and until next time, stay calm and embrace the rage.